Hello students, today I will discuss easiest way to represent a rational number on number line. So we will follow some steps. In the first step, what you have to do is write the rational number to be represented. So let it be 3 by 5. So I want to represent 3 by 5 on number line. So as a second step, you have to observe the denominator. As denominator is 5, so draw a line of 5 centimeter. If we have been asked to draw 7 by 9, then 9 would have been in denominator, and then you have to draw the line of 9 centimeter. Now write numbers from 0 to 5 as shown below. So what you have to do is, we have to draw a line of 5 centimeters as is given on the scale. You can easily see that we have a line of 5 centimeter. Then we have markings at 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter and 5 centimeter. Now write numbers from 0 to 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now divide each of these numbers by 5. So 0 divided by 5, 1 divided by 5, 2 divided by 5, 3 divided by 5, 4 divided by 5 and 5 divided by 5. 5 divided by 5 gives you 1. That means we have from 0 to 1, it is representing 1 unit of 5 centimeters. Now 1 unit is divided into 5 equal parts and we have to find third part out of 5 parts. So 3 parts out of 5 parts is represented by this point. So this is rational number 3 by 5 on number line. So mark 3 by 5 on number line. Now, what if the question is asked to represent 7 by 5 on number line? See, now the method is a little bit different. You just have to observe denominator. It is 5. So draw a line of 5 centimeter as drawn above. Now we draw a line of 5 centimeter here, right? जैसे कि हमने पहले बनाई थी. Now again draw the line of 5 centimeter and mark numbers on it. 1 0 1 2 3 4 5. Now observe that numerator is greater than denominator. So in that case, whenever numerator is greater than denominator, extend the number line by 5 centimeter more. That means it becomes line of 10 centimeter now. Now we are going to extend this for 5 more centimeters so that it becomes a line of 10 centimeters, and we will have the markings. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now the step remains the same. Then divide each number by 5. So 0 upon 5, 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5, 5 upon 5, which is 1, 6 upon 5, 7 upon 5, 8 upon 5, 9 upon 5 and 10 upon 5, that gives you 2. Now what we have to mark is, we have to mark 7 upon 5, so this is my required rational number. Now let us move towards one more question. For example, if we want to represent let's just say 5 by 7 on number line. Now as a first step, observe denominator. It is 7. So draw a line of 7 centimeter. So draw a line of 7 centimeter. Here we are drawing a line of 7 centimeter. And draw markings on it, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now write numbers from 0 to 7 on it. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now divide each number by the same denominator, that is 7. So what we have is 0 upon 7, 1 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7 and 7 upon 7. 7 divided by 7 gives you 1. That means, and 0 divided by 7 is 0. That means this represents one unit is now divided into 7 equal parts, and we know that fraction 5 by 7 means 5 parts out of 7 equal parts. So we have to represent 5 by 7 on the number line. So here is our required number, that is 5 by 7. Now what if we want to represent 22 by 7. So to draw 22 by 7, we have to extend the 7 centimeter line till we obtain required number. So we will go on extending our line till we have the required number. So let us draw it for, let's say, 7 centimeter, then extending it to another 7 centimeter, then extending it to another centimeter, 7 centimeter, then again extending it to another 7 centimeter and drawing the markings on it. So we will write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, and 28. Now, as a next step, divide each number by 7. So, when you divide each number by 7, you will get the fractions. As you can see, the fractions are becoming 10 by 7, 11 by 7, 12 by 7, 13 by 7, and so on till 28 by 7. Now you will see that this large line of 28 by centimeter is now divided into 4 units. This is 28 divided by 7 gives you 4, 21 divided by 7 gives you 3, 14 divided by 7 gives you 2, and 7 divided by 7 gives you 1. Now we have divided this line into 4 units, and to represent 22 by 7, it is very much visible on the number line that 22 by 7 is a fraction which gives us 3 point something. So basically it will come after third unit. So this is how we represent 28 by 7. Now let's talk about representing minus 5 by 6 on number line. How to represent minus 5 by 6 on number line? The procedure remains the same. As we can see that denominator is 6, so draw a line of 6 centimeter. So you have to draw a line of 6 centimeter. Here we have drawn a line of 6 centimeter and draw markings on it. So here are our markings. So on the extreme right marking, write 0. So earlier we were using 0 on the extreme left marking. Now we are using 0 on the extreme right marking. So we will go towards left as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. Write 0 and move towards left from 0, writing numbers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. Now divide each number by 6. So when you divide each number by 6, you will get fractions, and 6 divided by 6 gives you 1. So this is 1 in opposite direction, that is minus 1. So you want to represent minus 5 by 6. So here is your fraction. You can mark it, and if you want to show better, you can extend it and put arrows so that it's easier to see on a number line format. So what if we want to represent minus 7 by 6 on number line. So again the procedure is same, you have to take a line of 6 centimeter and then mark 0 and move towards the left and extend it to 6 centimeter more. So this is the case where we extend our line and start making the markings. So now we have extended it. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But in negative. So we will affix minus sign with each number. Now what we have to do is, we have to divide each number by 6. So 0 upon 6, minus 1 upon 6, minus 2 upon 6 and so on. That means this line of 12 centimeter is actually representing 2 units. Here is minus 1, here is minus 2, because minus 12 divided by 6 gives you 2. But in the opposite direction. So minus represents opposite direction. So we wanted to represent minus 7 by 6. So here is our rational number, that is minus 7 by 6. So students, thank you very much for patiently listening. And as an assignment, you have to represent following numbers, that is 7 by 8, 4 by 9, 3 by 11, 5 by 13 on number line as a part of positive, and minus 5 by 9, minus 13 by 10, minus 6 by 5, and 4 minus 4 by 3 on number line. So thank you very much and stay tuned for more videos.